I was driving into work when one of our employees, Heidi, called me about the pregnant dog underneath the underpass not far from the rescue.
The abdomen is huge, but I don't know that for sure it's pregnant.
Maybe it's in heart failure or it has like a tumor.
It's one of the largest abdomens I've ever seen.
Although it would be very hard for us to take on a litter of puppies right now, I would rather it be a female dog that's pregnant than a dog who is in heart failure that is that severe, because the chances of survival are pretty small.
Oh my God.
Are you sick? Or do you have babies? Or are you a boy? Hi. It's dirty and there's glass and the whole thing is just pretty heartbreaking.
I'm gonna just get a little closer to see how it reacts to me.
Hi, my angel. Hi. Are you sick?
You want the wet food?
Yeah. Maybe it'll like this chicken. Yeah, it's using its abdominal muscles to breathe, and normally that's hard. The dog was breathing using its abdominal muscles, and that's another sign of heart failure.
Okay, yeah, food's not gonna work.
I did try to toss it some food just to gain some trust, and it smelled it but had no interest in eating. Another really bad sign.
Okay, I'm just gonna have to go up to it.
I'm just gonna take my chances on you. Okay. You're just not feeling well, okay? Okay. Can you walk? Oh! Look at it from over here. Come over here. She's fine with people. Look at how. I know. Okay, baby, can you walk? I don't think she can walk. Okay, baby. This dog is in really bad shape. Wow. This is a boy. It's in heart failure.
Thank God. It's not pregnant.
I've seen a lot of dogs come in heart failure, and this is the largest abdomen I've ever seen.
Oh my God, I feel so bad pushing on it. It's okay, love. It's okay, we're gonna help you. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Oh my God.
This dog was extremely sick, and we needed to get to the vet right away.
I'll take care of you.
Heidi and I were trying to come up with a name that we felt was suitable for him, and we landed on Sebastian. He just looked like a Sebastian. It just seemed like that was his name. We got him to the vet as quickly as possible.
Where are we going? Oh, right there.
Some
of ours are like pretty.
He's kind of sliding now.
Oh, never mind.
Hey,
oh,
babe, man.
Spell,
though.
Spell.
Oh.
Okay.
Here we go, sweetie. Oh, man.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah, he's pretty pale. All right.
He was very, very weak. His gum color was very, very pale. And his abdomen, of course, was extremely distended and it palpated as fluid. So I was, you know, immediately concerned that we needed to get him stabilized quickly and sort out the underlying problem going on.
It's a really, really high-grade murmur. Mm-hmm. Sounds like both sides of the heart.
So it could, of course, be primary heart disease or heartworm, like severe heartworm. I'm sure you guys have seen some. Definitely looks like heart failure fluid.
When I see that amount of fluid, it did look characteristic of heart failure fluid to me. What I didn't know was that a primary heart condition he had, or was that secondary to heartworm disease?
You think he might be in cable?
It's possible. I don't think he's quite in cable, but he could be close to that direction.
Cable syndrome is when you have almost like a bunch of heartworms that have dislodged themselves. And usually that dog presents, you know, in collapse in a very serious condition, and he's right there.
Yeah, we definitely need to drain a lot of this off. That's why his breathing is so labored, because he has so much pressure on his diaphragm. We definitely need to get some x-rays of his heart and then drain all this fluid. I'm guessing we'll probably get about a liter off of him.
We've seen dogs in similar condition not as bad and not make it. So you want to keep hope, but it's really hard.
So it was high heartworm positive, like microfilaria everywhere. I don't think we're quite in cable yet, although I think we could be teetering on that, and we're super, super high risk for during treatment.
Even though we sort of expected that prognosis, it still hurts to hear that. And you just immediately think about the life that this dog has had and that it's probably been horrible.
So all of this whiteness back here is just his pulmonary vasculature that's super dilated and enlarged from the amount of worms that he has.
That's his heart pushing.
Yeah, his heart being enlarged too.
And that's why he's coughing. Yeah. Like chuffing, I guess. Mm-hmm.
Sebastian's x-rays showed a severely enlarged heart from the burden of worms that are living in it. So the actual veins coming down from the heart that are supplying the lungs were extremely dilated, and that's because they're actually filled with worms. And the pressure is extremely high in those too from the worms being there.
What do you say the percentage rate of him surviving is?
At this point, 35 maybe, through all of treatment. I could tell by his x-rays that we were in a serious state. You know, I think right now we start with getting the heart more functional, draining the fluid, getting him stabilized. And if he makes it through the stabilization, then we move into the treatment phase.
Okay.
So it's really gonna be very step-by-step with him.
All we can do is hope for the best and hope that he makes it through the night and wait for an update.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. It's been a couple of days since Heidi and I brought Sebastian in.
Oh man.
Wow.
Definitely looks like heart failure fluid. Yeah, we definitely need to drain a lot of this off.
So we are here to check on Sebastian.
Hi!
Look, he says hello.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, look how much smaller.
He looks so different.
It was amazing just to see him walking and to see his belly so much smaller. Unfortunately, once all the fluid was drained, you could see how skinny he was. That just kind of shows that we were right to think that nobody was caring for this dog for a very long time.
Remember when we thought you were pregnant?
He's so precious. I love him. I'm so attached, it's terrible. His personality is just sweet. He wants to be taken care of. He likes it when I sit in there with him and feed him by hand. He's loving all this love and attention.
It's so beautiful.
He gets so excited when we like approach his kennel. Like he wags his tail because he's like, I'm gonna get some chicken or go on a walk. He's just a very gentle dog.
So do we think his percentage of living is higher?
I think it's higher. I mean, I'd still probably say 50-50 at this point.
That's better than 35%, yeah.
After 2 days, he's really made great strides. He's gone above what I expected for him. Without 6.5 liters on him, he's much more comfortable when he's resting, and he looks pretty good. I feel like we can get his heart stabilized, just how well he's responded to the heart meds within 24 hours. It's just gonna be if he can make it through the treatment. Those heartworm treatments that we do to kill the adult worms are very dangerous. It's necessary, but dangerous. He literally has, you could think of like spaghetti in his heart right now. So as we're killing these worms and they die off, we worry that one of them could break off and actually cause like a clot and almost a stroke-like event for them. There you go.
He's tired.
He's tired.
Let's let him rest.
I think he's extremely lucky. I'm not sure that he would have made it another night. I mean, he was critical. He is scheduled for an echocardiogram, which is an ultrasound of his heart. That will give us an idea of where we've gotten medication-wise and, you know, setting the timeline going forward. I'm still, you know, concerned. I want him to pull through, but just having seen what I've seen, I know that it can be very dangerous and he has a lot of steps left in this process.
Hi, Sebastian.